Great. Okay. Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Moodle Academy webinar, Design Thinking Process, Exploring Ideation. So in this webinar, we're going to be talking about the ideation phase of the design thinking process. It's a brief overview of the stage, and we're going to have like some practical activity, and we hope you enjoy the session. Also, it's important to mention that this is a second webinar of design thinking that we do in Moodle Academy. We did the first one, and we're going to be talking as well in the next few slides around what we spoke in the other one. It's important to mention that you, if you have with you pen pen and paper, would be great if you can be ready with it, because we're going to do an activity of ideation. Okay. So just to present, I am Federico Astorga. I'm the UX designer in the Moodle community, and I am super happy to be also presenting with Zoe Rippon. She's the Experience Design Manager here at Moodle.
Hi, everyone. Say hi, Zoe.
Right. So it's important before actually starting talking about ideation to have very clear the design thinking process, the concept of it. Okay. So as you can see on the image on the right, it's an iterative process, and teams use this process to understand users, to challenge assumptions, and also redefine problems and create innovative solutions to prototype and test. This is a really good definition from that you can find also in interactiondesign.org. It's a really good source of information. But just to give you a bit of context, so we're going to be talking about the third phase, because when we start the design thinking process, we start from the empathize, and then we go to define stage. And these two, we can group them as understanding the problem space. Okay. After defining the problem, we go to the ideation stage, is the one we're going to talk today. And then we have other two stages that we're going to speak just very little at the end of the presentation. There's some context around the design thinking process. And also, before jumping into ideation, it's really important to define clearly the problem, okay? Because this is going to set the context inside everyone's minds that is also like collaborating with the ideation process, so we can actually think in the same direction, let's say. So we have to go through the empathize and define problem. And to understand these two stages of the design thinking process a bit more in detail, I want to recommend you also to see the first webinar that we did that is called Design Thinking Process, How to Empathize with Users and Define the Problem. So you have a QR code if you want to have a look right now with your phone, or we also include the YouTube link here. And also, it's important to mention that the design thinking process is something that actually anyone can apply into their workflow. We're not talking, it's something very specific, right? It can be applied. I mean, all designers should apply the design thinking process, but it can be involved anyone. And we actually recommend bringing like different ideas, and you will see why this is so important to involve other people. In the importance of the ideation step, sometimes this stage of the design thinking process is like squeezed out of the workflow because many people don't consider it super important. But the fact that it has its own stage inside the design thinking process is the reason of actually bringing it to or consider it, okay, inside your project. Because ideation allows us to explore many varied possible solutions to a problem or opportunity space. Oftentimes, there are nuggets of brilliant, innovative solution in some of the most far out ideas. And we are going to give you some recommendations on how to actually implement this. So we really encourage you to work on this. Okay. And now I'm going to pass it on to Zoe. She's going to help walk us through. Thanks, Zoe.
Thanks, Betty. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining today. I volunteered myself to talk about ideation because it's one of the funnest steps in this process, and I really enjoy this part of the process. So I'm going to share with you a couple of things and go through, as Fedi mentioned, a couple of fun activities that we can do that hopefully you can take away and do in your own teams after you've learned them today. So one of the first questions is like, where should we start? I always find it best to start with the outputs that you get from your empathize and define stages, which Fedi spoke about just previously. When we move through these stages, we often come out of it with problem or opportunity areas. And these are the things that we really want to be prioritizing and then bringing into ideation. So obviously, there might be some projects that you come out of, you know, with maybe 20 problem opportunities or areas, and we can't take all of those into ideation. So before we bring things into ideation, you probably want to have a little discussion with your team or relevant stakeholders about what are the most important problem spaces or opportunity areas that you could focus on, and those are the ones that you want to bring into ideation. And if you did join us in the previous webinar, you'd be familiar with something that we spoke about, which were need statements. These are very similar to what we have on the right in the pink sticky there, which is how might we statement. So these are just ways we can start to form the question around our problem or opportunity area to make them a little bit easier to work with, particularly when we go into ideation. So for the purposes of today, we've made it very simple and very straightforward, something we can all kind of understand quite easily. So for a need statement, we have Federico needs to keep his coffee warm on the way to work so he can enjoy a drink with his colleagues in the morning. Or if we were to craft that in a how might we statement, it might look something like, how might we keep a cup of coffee warm on the morning commute? So those are the things that we recommend taking into your ideation. If we move on to the next slide, please, Fedi, we're going to cover a couple of ground rules. So a lot of people go into ideation with their logical hat still on. The first rule of ideation is that we need to throw that out the window. This is the time where we need to be thinking really broadly, be thinking a bit crazy. So that's rule number one. Rule number two is that there's no right or wrong ideas. We really are trying to solicit anything that comes into the space for anyone that you're engaging in the ideation with. Which brings us to number three, which is no idea is too crazy. Fedi mentioned just earlier that some of the most innovative solutions are born out of some of the craziest ideas, and it might be a tiny drop of that crazy idea, but if somebody didn't come up with that crazy idea, then we might not have said innovative solution to start with. Number four, and I've learned this by experience, is that if you feel a little bit silly when you're doing it and you kind of laugh to yourself and you're like, can I actually draw that or write that down? That probably means you're doing it right and that you're letting yourself be creative and you're thinking of some crazy different ideas. Number five is that the first thing that pops into your head, go with that. Oftentimes, people will have an idea come into their head and then their analytical mind will start telling them, oh, well, that's not going to work for this reason, or we can't do that for that reason. We don't want to listen to that. Just go with it. And number six is obviously have some fun and let your imagination come out to play. So with that being said, if we can move on to the next slide, Fedi. We're going to run through a little warm-up activity. And so for successful ideation, we really need to access the right-hand side of our brain. So the part that's responsible for daydreaming, imagination, holistic thinking. And we're going to share this activity that you can use and hopefully you can take away and use with your teams to encourage that side of the brain. So as Fedi said, make sure you've got a pen and a piece of paper. You can write these down. If you don't have a pen and paper, you can type them out if you like. At the end of the first round of what we're going to be doing, I'm going to ask you all to please share in the chat the number that you write down. So how many things you write down. And I love this quote on the right-hand side here from Albert Einstein, which is, to stimulate creativity, one must develop the childlike inclination for play. So I hope you're all ready to play. All right. Can we have some? Oh, we're there. All right, Fedi. So Fedi's going to set a timer for 30 seconds. The first activity we're going to do is I want you all to tell me what this is. So when we start the timer, not yet, write down as many things as you think this could be. Fedi, give us the wave when you've got the 30 seconds on the timer and he'll let us know when we're done.
Hi. Are you ready?
Let's go.
Let's go.
Many things as you think this could be.
We have 20 seconds.
Love it. People sharing in the chat. Keep going. As many things as you think it could be.
Very great. 3, 2, 1. All right.
All right. Can everybody share how many things they wrote down? How many things did you think this could be? Three. Cool. Two. Nice, Sarah. Three, Amaya. Two.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
All right. That's good, but I think we can do better. And the reason I say that is I asked a child what this is a real life child. Mine wasn't around, so I asked one of my friend's children what this could be. And Fetty, can you start clicking away, please? I can't even remember how many she said. Two. What do we got? Lots of these came through. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. So that was 10, and she kind of was, you know, cool, I'll answer your question, Auntie Zoe. But so as you can see, like, children just throw out 1,000 different things. They don't let their logical brain kind of go, Like the first time I did this activity, I looked at this for a long time and I was like looking at it sideways. And I had probably one or two answers to this question. So angry face is the best. So we're going to give you another round. And I really want to see if we get that number up. So Fetty, can you set the timer and move to the next? My picture's gone all funny. Is that just me? I'm all blurry. Anyway.
Yeah, it's true.
Can we go to the next
picture? Yeah, we can move to the next one. I have the timer ready.
All right.
All right. And go.
So this one, let's go. Oh, a broom. Love that. Fireworks. Tree. I haven't heard tree. That's
we have 20 seconds.
One. A match lighting up. That's another great one. A spider.
We have 10 seconds.
Oh, I'm hoping these numbers are going up. I'm hopeful.
3, 2, 1. All right.
All right. What have we got, guys? How many?
A cartoon character. Yeah.
5, 4. Yes. Very good. Anyone else? 3. Andreas, I'd love for you to share the 5 that you came up with. If you're up for
Lily had, Lily had 2 before and now she has 3. So I'd say that's definitely
firework, moth.
Success.
Octopus. That's a great one. Love that. Stick with hair. Red pole with wires. Awesome. Flowers. Love that, Sarah. A dead spider. Good one, Julia. So yeah, as you can see, like, once we give ourselves the permission to not think it has to be something, our brain starts to let us play a little bit. So I really love this activity because it's quite quick and it's a little bit of fun. So please feel free to take the pictures, draw your own pictures. And use this if you ever want to. It can be a good icebreaker, but to start an ideation. All right, on to the next one, Fetty. So before we get into our own little mini version of ideation, I just want to say that, you know, sometimes I get the questions around, well, I don't know how to do ideation. Like, what method should I use or how do I do it? To be honest, there are so many methods and activities that can be used to facilitate ideation. And a lot of the time, people will just take bits and pieces and use them in the best way to fit their context. So I really encourage you to go and look online. There's plenty of books. Go and have a look at what's out there and don't be afraid to try them, because some of them will be great and you'll love them. And some of them you'll be like, oh, that was a flop. That didn't work. But you learn and you might have a little piece of that that you want to learn for the next time. So feel free to take them. Don't feel like you have to do them by the letter. Adjust them to suit the situation you're in or the context that you're in. And there are some suggestions at the end of the slides to some resources for some of the more common ideation methods that are out there that you may have also heard of. All right, next slide, Betty. So For the purposes of today, we're going to be leveraging a method called the Crazy Eight. For anyone that has heard of ideation, you've probably heard people speak of this method. Today, we're going to be using a condensed version, so don't worry. We're not going to ask you to do eight rounds. That can be a bit intense. But this method is traditionally quite fast-paced and a rapid ideation. And so I did want to share with you what it does look like if you were to do the full version, which is Fetty's put a little diagram on the right there where you're meant to fold your piece of paper into eight separate sections. And then somebody will have the job of having the timer and setting eight rounds of 1 minute rounds with no break in between. And so each person would sketch one idea per minute on one of the eight squares. And hopefully by the end, you have eight different ideas sketched out. And I can tell you from doing the full version a few times, I reckon I've got there maybe once. It is really hard and it does push your brain quite a lot, but try it out because it's really fun to just get in there and give it a go to see if you can come up with eight different ideas for the one problem area. So if everybody's got their piece of paper and pen ready, we're going to get into our little condensed version for today's webinar. Fetty, can you go to the next slide? So we're going to use the same very fun need statement or how might we, whichever one resonates most with you today, which is about Federico keeping his cup of coffee warm on the way to work. So depending on which one you feel lights your brain up in the right way, we've got Federico needs to keep his coffee warm on the way to work so he can enjoy a drink with his colleagues in the morning. Or how might we keep a cup of coffee warm on the morning commute? So there are, I'm sure, going to be some weird and wonderful ideas to these two prompts. And so how we're going to roll with this is Fetty's got a timer on the next slide that has 3 minutes on the clock. We did have a timer. There it is. Yep. So he'll call out when each minute passes. And at that point, we'd love you to move on to the next idea. So if you've got your piece of paper, maybe just draw a line and make it into three sections. And you'll have a minute to sketch out as much detail for that idea that's come into your head. You can use words, you can use pictures, whatever it is. Get it down on the paper. And then when he calls time of that minute, we'll move on to the next minute. Once we've finished those 3 minutes, we would really, really love you to take a photo on your phone and email it through to me. What I'm going to attempt to do, and I apologize if it doesn't work in this very moment, but I'm going to attempt as quickly as I can to get these onto a slide that we'll look at so we can see some of the awesome things that come out of this together on the webinar. But if that doesn't happen, then we will share them after the webinar. So as soon as we're finished, we'll give a little bit of time. You guys can email your photos of your piece of paper through to us. And that will be it. Is there any questions before we get into it? We might jump back to the prompt, Eddie.
Yeah. Like I wrote the prompt also in the chat. So
oh, okay, cool. That's great. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Alrighty. We'll just give 1 second for questions. Otherwise, yeah, let's get into it. I think we're good to go.
We can start, I guess. Yeah. Okay. Let's go. 3 minutes.
We should have included some music, like on the Miro board.
Right, so you have 40 seconds to end the first one, right? And then... Right, 15 seconds. right? So you should be already in the second one. Seconds to end the second one. Yeah, we should be already in the third one. We have 50 seconds left. Right, we have 20 seconds. We're almost there. Right. Thanks, over.
Alrighty. I'm going to keep on the refresh of my emails and see if we get some of them coming in. If it takes a bit long, then we can go to plan B.
Yeah, we're still like, it's also important to mention that we all were exactly where the recording is going to be. We put it on YouTube, where we also put it in Academy. So we might be able to put like these sketches, some of the sketches with the recording.
Yeah.
Inside Moodle Academy.
All right. I think we might have to go to plan B because my email is struggling. All right, let's continue. And if they come through before the end and I can get them up, then, oh, we've got a few. Let's see. Oh, I have Sarah. Oh, okay. I think the document is also struggling, so we may have to go to option two. But I can give you a little bit of an insight into what I have received, which is a cup jumper. Love that. Hot lockers on the train. That is a great one. Inside pocket keeps Fetty warm too. I think it's like, oh, you pour it into a jacket. That looks very cool.
I think that sounds amazing.
And then we have putting a scarf to the cup, asking for a super hot coffee, and asking for the office manager to buy a coffee machine. Well, that seems very logical. Good suggestion. What else? I'll just quickly check if we have anything else that has come through.
Yeah, that's a main idea, no? Like I would have never thought on things like that, on those ideas, you know? That's great.
Nothing is yet. So let's keep going. But thank you for those that sent through. That's super awesome to see. Alrighty, next step, Fetty. So that was a really very quick introduction to ideation and some of the things that you can expect when going into an ideation workshop. But just to round out with a couple of recommendations. So at a high level, for a successful ideation, we really want to use the prompts from your empathize and define stage. As I said, these are the pain points and the opportunities that came out of that stage. And you really want to make sure that you're prioritizing the highest important ones that you think you could tackle. I very, very much recommend taking the time to do the warm-up activity. As I said, it shifts the state of people's brains a little bit, helps them to feel a little bit more creative, and can really reap benefit when you're maybe undertaking a couple of different methods that really require people to do it for a longer period, much longer period of time than we did. It's important at this point in the process that we don't judge the ideas proposed. Obviously, we need to judge them at some point in the process, but that comes a bit later. We really just want to make sure that we're welcoming all of the ideas that come with open arms. And quantity is better than quality at this point in the process. That is not true for the rest of the process necessarily, but this is all about generating a high volume of crazy and wonderful ideas. And then if you can, it's always better to ideate with other people. Of course, if you're in a situation where you can ideate on your own or the alternative is nothing, ideating on your own is definitely the way to go. But if you can, it's always nice, and you can really obviously get diversity of thought when you include your team or your stakeholders, users or non-users, depending on the product you're working on, community members in our instance, friends, family, pretty much anyone. If you have clear enough defined prompts, like your need statement or your how might we statement, it should be very easy for somebody to read that and then be able to interpret for themselves what that means and all of the ideas that they have to solve it. It doesn't necessarily have to happen through a workshop, but it can be a nice way to give the attention that this deserves, and get people focused and in that flow of creativity. So that is it for our very short whistle stop tour of ideation this evening. To you, Fede.
Yeah. So I'm going to talk a bit about, okay, so what happens after ideation? And we have to come back to the concept of design thinking process, because as I mentioned before, the last stages that come after ideate, then it comes prototype and test. So it's once we have an idea or like a few ideas in place that we really like and we think they're going to work, we like the next stage would be to create a interactive, very simple version of our idea so we can actually bring it back to users and to validate if this idea is actually solving the problem, right? And they say they involve users again in the process because design thinking process starts, we empathize. And there is where we actually also gather the information from the users. So that's why I recommend to watch the first webinar. And we are not covering in detail like prototype and test in this webinar either. So I encourage you to stay tuned because we're going to be presenting more about the design thinking process, right? And as we mentioned in other slides, we have here a list of resources that we put together. But this is just a really, really tiny list of all the amazing resources that you can find there. Yeah, we have a few to learn more about what we talked today. And also we have suggested like methods or activities like to do with your team. And you will see some of the links is just like list of a bunch of suggested methods, and we encourage you to try them out. And that's the best way to actually learn this ideation, just actually do it. And the last bullet point is just, there's much more in the internet that I also encourage you to have a look and explore. It's really important, like the source. So you will see that some of the links are from like Nielsen Norman Group. You have also Interaction Design Foundation. They're great, great websites with, they also are posting all the time. So there is a lot to see. And we wanted to put some time as well for questions. We have some people asking for the email. So I send it again in case you want to send it, and we are going to add it later. But I didn't see any question coming up here. So if you have any questions, please drop it in the chat. Also, nice comments like, what do you think about the webinar? That's also great. Doesn't have to be necessarily a question.
I'd love to hear if anybody's attempted or done or does ideation in their day-to-day work, and if they have anything to add to what we've covered.
Yeah, or if you try like a different kind of activity or icebreaker, that's also nice. I'm gonna try the jacket on, like the coffee on the pocket option. I don't like to do it.
Don't burn yourself, Fede, please.
I need to prototype that. But yeah, if we don't have any other, like any question in the chat, I mean, we can have here, so we have some comment from Julia. I don't usually do ideation using the crazy egg technique, but I definitely try to use it more. It does unlock the brain. I completely agree. There's actually one of the resources. I'm going to go back. We have here, where do you put it? So the third point of the learn more resources, it says ideation is a mindset. And that's a really, really good video that explains that ideation not necessarily has to happen with a specific context in a workshop or something, but it's just something that you can apply actually throughout the process. So I really recommend you that to watch that video. It's really good. We have another comment. Very helpful webinar. It's effectively participate when you're in the middle of work. I like to create it and I will share it with the rest of the team. That sounds amazing, Lydia. Thank you.
As I said, just to wrap up, ideation is actually where adults get to play like children. So please think about it like that, like embrace it as a part of the process that we get to have a little bit of fun and be a bit crazy, because that's how I always think about it. And I really love ideation. It's also such a great way to get some really nice engagement from stakeholders or users, community members, because everybody's having fun. So yeah. A lovely part.
Yeah, great. I think we can wrap up. Just one thing to mention as well before end the webinar. We want to like thank you for coming to this presentation. And we have like the experience lab in Moodle. You have there like the URL is moodle.org/experience lab, and you can sign up there to be part of like research projects that we're going through, so you can actually help improve Moodle and be part of all these kind of the design thinking process that we apply when we gather information from you. So you're the best person that you can let us know how we can improve and what kind of problems are you facing there. So we're going to encourage you to be part of that. Right. And that would be the presentation. I just have to mention a few things, right? Also about Moodle Academy that is helping us to host this webinar. So if you enjoyed this session, we would love you to consider getting involved further and help us grow by contributing to the development of Moodle Academy. You can do this by visiting the Get Involved course that we have in Moodle Academy, moodle.academy, which you will find on the front page of the Moodle Academy site. You can suggest ideas for new webinars and courses, and you can vote on ideas that have been suggested by others already. And we're always on the lookout for community members to help present webinars and co-create short online courses. So yeah, we have love your help. We would love your help to make Moodle Academy like more inclusive. If you are able to, please jump into a translate Moodle Academy course, get started with helping us translate courses and webinars into other languages. Right. And then also help spread the word. About Moodle Academy, like by telling your colleagues or courses we have, about your courses, the courses we offer and the events we run. When you click course, you will learn a badge. Also, educators might like to think about getting involved with Moodle Educator Certificate. You can take the Are You Ready for MAC quiz, and one of our certified service providers will support you through the certification process. We really want to thank you for joining us today. I hope you find this useful, and yeah, I hope to see you in the Moodle Academy course forums and our upcoming webinars. If you have any further questions, you can leave them writing down in the discussion forum in the affiliate course of the Moodle Academy, the Moodle community for us to answer, okay? So yeah, thank you again, everyone, for joining us. And we hope to see you in other Moodle Academy webinars. Thank you, Zoe. And thank you for all
the
people that brought in the chat.